Hey guys!
This is finally the video all of you have been waiting for.
Or at least a lot of you.
A year later, we have
literally
finally doing our bookshelf tour.
So our last bookshelf tour was back in May, and right now it's May 2014, and we thought this is it. We've been meaning to do this bookshelf tour since like January of 2014, but now we're like, it's gonna happen.
Yep.
So it's gonna happen.
Yep.
So get ready. So the first part is just going to be an overview of all our bookshelves.
If you don't feel like watching the whole thing and watching every single book, you can just check out the books. Like,
yeah, we'll just do a really, really quick one. Maybe the first like 3 to 4 to 5 minutes. I'm not exactly sure. And then we'll get into more details on the second part of this bookshelf tour.
Yep.
So let's get started.
Yes. So this is the first shelf. As you can see, we have the paranormal with a bit of contemporary on this, and these are our hardbacks. Over here, you can see the continuation of our paranormal, and again, these are all hardbacks and our series. Over here, we have our dystopian paperbacks with a bit of contemporary and paranormal. Over here, we have a mix of everything: paranormal, dystopian, contemporary, and even some manga. Down here we have the adult books, so these are usually the ones that Johanna reads. I have not read any. Down below we have our middle grade books, the books that we read when we were younger, such as the Rick Riordan, the Babysitter's Club, and others.
Over here are our contemporaries, and they're all hardbacks, and some of them are actually some of our favorite contemporaries, so that's why we put them on this shelf. Our dystopians slash trilogies and duologies that are mostly complete and are in order. The third shelf includes a lot of our paranormal books. I think all of these books are paranormal. Moving on to our ARCs, all of these are advanced reader copies except for that Catching Fire movie companion and a couple of tiny two books at the end there. This is another ARC bookshelf, and most of these ARCs are ones that we've read. Lastly are a bit of our adult chiclets, a couple of like middle gradish books, some ARCs, as well as like one movie and some random books. So this is like the random shelf.
So back up here again, we have our paranormals, all our hardback paranormals,
and there's a bit of contemporaries too.
Here we have some random paranormal, contemporary, and some dystopian hardbacks, as well as the sweep, which are the paperbacks.
Over here is my sort of coveted shelf. I have my J.K. Rowling collection, including Harry Potter books, and over here are our two sets of the Twilight books, one for me and one for Farah. Here are our contemporary paperbacks. You'll notice we have a ton of contemporaries because, you know, I'm a big contemporary fan.
Down here we have all of our ARCs, all we have actually read, and they are not categorized, so they're a mix of paranormal, contemporary, dystopian, mine and Johanna's, so yes.
So going into more detail, the first book we have The Heist by Janet Ivanovich, The Gypsy King, Fat Vampire, A Need So Beautiful by Suzanne Young, Generation Dead, A Fairy Ring, Through to You, The Eye of Minds by James Dashner, An Address in Blood and Girl of Nightmares, Dark Eyes, The Body Finder, Desires of the Dead, Mask of the Red Death, Dearly Departed, Bittersweet by Sarah Auchler, Noggin. And over here we have Guardian by Heather Birch, Sweet Shadows, Harbinger, The Secret Sisterhood of Heartbreakers, The Innocents, LA Candy, two copies, Sugar and Spice, and Premeditated. Over here we have two copies of Red Rising by Pierce Brown, Anna Brasher's The Here and Now, Hilary Duff's The Elixir, the third and last book of Daughter of Smoke and Bone, which is Dreams of Gods and Monsters, also Venom by Fiona Paul, Valkyrie Rising, the second and third book of the Paranormalcy trilogy by Kirsten White, Hex Hall, Demon Glass, and Spellbound, all three books of the Rachel Hawkins books. There's Partials, Breathe, Parallel, Wither, the first book of the Chemical Garden trilogy, Hush Hush and Crescendo, the first two books of the Hush Hush series, Hourglass and Infinity, books 1 and 3 of the Myra McIntyre Hourglass trilogy. Two copies of Hemlock, one of them is actually an annotated copy sent to me by the author, which I truly covet. And the last are the first and second books of the Way We Fall dystopian trilogy.
Here we have Unlocked, Earth Girl, Sweet Little Lies by Lauren Conrad, Above,
the third book by Jennifer L. Armentrout, Opal. We have Trial of Fire and Raised by Wolves by Jennifer Lynn Barnes. We have Cress, An Arc, Cinder by Marissa Meyer. The Hunt and the Prey by Andrew Fukada. Shout Down, which is the third book. Scarlet, which is also an arc. Sever, Fever, and Wither, the trilogy by Lauren DeStefano. Here we have Slated by Terry Terry, Glow by Amy Kathleen Ryan, Unravel Me, Unite Me, Shatter Me, and Ignite Me, all by Tara Maffey. Pandemonium and Delirium by Lauren Oliver. And if you're wondering where Requiem is, it's actually currently with a friend right now. Here we have a paperback of Divergent, Inside Out and Outside In by Maria V. Schneider. We have Shadow and Bone,
which I truly, truly love. I just had to say that.
Yes. And we have the Vampire Academy series, all by Rochelle Mead, which I truly, truly love. I just had to say that.
Over here, we have Apollyon by Jennifer L. Armentrout. I'm pretty sure this is the fourth book in the Covenant series. I've read all five books. Rules of Summer, this is an arc. I don't even know what it's doing there. And then we have Across the Universe, Clockwork Angel and Prince by Cassandra Clare. Revamped by Ada Adams, Swoon, Under the Never Sky by Veronica Rossi, which I just love this trilogy. Shadowfall, The Beginning by C.C. Hunter. Angel Fall, have not read that. Evernight, Carrier of the Mark, I really didn't like Carrier of the Mark. Ruling Passion, Paranormalcy, which is book one that I didn't show earlier. Fateful by Claudia Gray, Catastrophic History of You and Me, we actually have a hardback copy. And here is Farah's collection of her manga, Ultramaniac, all five books. Emma Doki, another five books, and the Death Note series, all 12 books. So here is my chicklet books. We have A Girl Thing by Sarah O'Brien, Janet Ivanovich Motormouth, Josephine Cox's Live the Dream, Leila Dehan's Keep Your Feet Hidden. Then I have Sophie Kinsella's Mini Shopaholic, Girls of Riyadh, Claire Dowling's My Fabulous Divorce, another Sophie Kinsella book, Remember Me. I have here my Jane Austen books, Mansfield Park, Emma, Pride and Prejudice, Persuasion, If You Could See Me Now by Cecily Ahern, Keeping It in the Family by Sinead Moriarty, The Time Traveler's Wife, which I actually got from a library for 25 cents, You Drive Me Crazy by Carol Matthews, Wish Upon a Star, Margaret Atwood's Lady Oracle, Summer at the Villa Road. And then of course here is my favorite book, chicklet book ever, Can You Keep a Secret by Sophie Kinsella, Monday's Child by Louise Backshaw, Further Under the Dovet, No Strings Attached, With or Without You, Book Lover, Exit A, Fabulous Things, Temptation, Johnny B. Good, The Lotus Eater, Every Boy's Got One by Mike Cabot, which I didn't really enjoy, and another Margaret Atwood book. Here's another Louise Backshaw book, Tuesday's Child, Meg Cabot's Queen of Babel, and my Sophie Kinsella books, Shopaholic, all the Shopaholic series, as well as some Nicholas Sparks books, including Message in a Bottle, Motherland, Rachel's Holiday, and another Sophie Kinsella book.
Over here I have Diary of a Wimpy Kid, series Mira's Diary, Interrupted by Rachel Coker, Blue Sky Freedom, the Rick Riordan series, The Next Big Thing, So Super Scary, some junior high books, and The Babysitter's Club by Anne M. Martin. I have The Old Man and the Sea, The Hobbit, Small Steps by Lewis Sacker, which by the way is the second book of Holes. I realize not a lot of people know that. The Whispering Road, some Julia D. Villar series, So Super Stylish, The God of Animals, Two of Us, On the Prowl, Clean Break by Jacqueline Wilson, The Lottery Project, again by Jacqueline Wilson, Avalon High by my favorite Meg Cabot,
which I really loved, but when I watched the movie was really bad.
Wrecked and Starting Over by Kathy Hopkins, which is a very good author. Over here we have After the Funeral and Unfinished Portrait, both by Agatha Christie. And we have The Giver Edition, Tuck Everlasting, Far From You. We have the three books from the Lovecraft Middle School. Then we have Flowers, Breathing Underwater, Project Sweet Life, Fall From Grace, and Tommy Sullivan is a Freak by Meg Cabot.
Which I love. Over here we have our favorite shelf, the Contemporary, with the first, The Statistical Probability of Love at First Sight by Jennifer E. Smith, Pushing the Limits and Dare You To by Katie McGurry, the first two, High Society and Perfect Scoundrels by Ali Carter, Just One Day, The Probability of Miracles, Such a Rush,
which I love, guys, read the book,
20s Girl by Sophie Kinsella, Smart Girls Get What They Want,
love
North
it.
Of Beautiful,
love
Fan
it.
Girl,
love it.
To All the Boys I've Loved Before by Jenny Han, and we had to get two copies because it's Jenny Han, guys.
And we got them both signed. So.
And then The French Kiss and The Long Boy Next Door by Stephanie Perkins, We Were Liars by E. Lockhart, Bells, Boys, Bears, and a series
pair of hiking boots, How to Take the Ex Out of the Ex-Boyfriend, 2 copies of We'll Always Have Summer by, again, Jenny Han, Winter Girls by Laurie Hollis Anderson, which I have to tell you guys is one of my all-time favorite books ever, 20 Boys Summer by Sarah Auchler, being Sloane Jacobs, and Girl Overboard.
So here is another one of my coveted dystopian shelves. Have The Hunger Games, Catching Fire and Mockingjay, Divergent, 2 copies of Insurgent, and Allegiant, Legend, Champion, and Here is Prodigy, but my friend currently is reading it. Pivot Point and Split Second by Casey West. This is a duology. I read the first book last year and I fell in love with it. And I currently, like recently got the second one, so I'm dying to read it. Unraveling and Unbreakable by Elizabeth Norris. Not a lot of people know this, but this is actually only a duology. I was waiting for the third book, and this is why I didn't read Unbreakable, but apparently it's over, so I'm excited to read it. Cinder and Scarlet by Marissa Mayer.
This series is probably an amazing dystopian series. It is crazy, crazy fun, and definitely a series you have to read if you have not read.
Grave Mercy and Dark Triumph, books 1 and 2 of His Fair Assassins trilogy. I've only read Grave Mercy and fell in love with it, and I'm dying to read Dark Triumph. I heard the best things about it. The Girl of Fire and Thorns, as well as The Crown of Embers by Ray Carson, and The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer and The Evolution of Mara Dyer by Michelle Hodkin, one of my all-time favorite books ever.
And one of my all-time favorite covers ever.
Yeah, Fada hasn't read them yet, but I will convert her. And the third book's coming out in November, my birthday month, so I'm dying for it. I cry a little bit inside knowing that it's so far away, but this is an amazing paranormal psychological thriller. You guys all should pick it up, and it has the best covers ever.
Then we have Gone by Michael Grant, Iron Daughter, and The Iron King by Julie Kagawa, Every Never After, Once Every Never by Leslie Livingston, War on Bodies, You're So Undead to Me, The Storyteller, Wake by Lisa McMahon, Immortal Beloved by Kate Ternan, another copy of War on Bodies, The Dark Divine, Touch, Some Quiet Place by Kelsey Sutton, The Demon's Covenant, Hex Hall, Forbidden, Unearthly, Social Suicide, and Deadly Cool, Spellbound, Demon Glass, and Hex Hall, the series by Rachel Hawkins, Ascend, Torn, and Switched by Amanda Hawking. And by the way, this series is probably so, so good. I really cannot wait to read the third book. Another Leslie Livingston book, Once Every Never, Julie Kagawa's The Eternity Cure, Angel, and Angel Fire by L.A. Weatherly. Then we have Nightshade by Andrea Kremer, which by the way is a really, really good book, but I heard really bad things about the series overall. And then we have the City of Bones series by Cassandra Clare. Then we have Shiver, Linger, and Forever by Maggie Stiefvater.
So here is the arcs, and the first couple are ones that we haven't read actually. There's Since You've Been Gone by Morgan Matson that Farah is currently reading, and it has the best cover ever. Don't You Forget About Me by Kate Carey's Quinn, Monument 14 Savage Drift Tees. I've actually mentioned this in my previous, bookshelf tour, and I've mentioned it in a couple of videos, but this is one of my all-time favorite books. I recently reread it and I love it. It is new adult, but it's completely different from the typical new adult books. It breaks my heart, and I've reread it, as I mentioned, without skipping a single line. So contemporary fans, you definitely need to pick this book up. The Ring and the Crown, The Dark World, To All the Boys I've Loved Before, our art copy, My Life with the Walter Boys by Ali Novak, a lot of fun that book is, Forget Me by K.A. Harrington, Empowered by Jessica Shervington, the fifth and last book in the Viola Eden chapter series, Biggest Flirts by Jennifer Eccles, another fun book, A Mad and Wicked Folly. Then we've got Heartbeat by Elizabeth Scott, a very heart-wrenching book, Panic by Lauren Oliver,
which is actually a very good contemporary. It has I thought it was a dystopian book, but it's a really, really, really good contemporary with a lot of twist of the games or whatnot, so if you're a fan of contemporary, you should totally pick this one up.
Vengeance by Megan Miranda, Broken Hearts, Fences, and Other Things to Mend, and this is actually by Morgan Matson under her pseudonym. There's Fire with Fire by Jenny Han and Siobhan Vivian, 17 First Kisses, How to Love by Katie Kotugno. This is another one of like the books that I fell in love with. It's a contemporary. It reminds me a lot of Shout Down the Moon, as well as The Rescue by Nicholas Sparks, and I loved it so much, I can't recommend it enough, and every time I recommend it to someone, they love it. So contemporary fans, you need to read this book. The Impossible Knife of Memory by Laurie Hollis Anderson.
Another great Laurie Hollis Anderson book, another all-time favorite of mine, and this book is definitely, it has so much more, it just means so much more to me than just a book. Contemporary fans out there who are looking for a heart-wrenching and meaningful book should totally pick this one up.
The Beginning of Everything by Robin Schneider, Smart Girls Get What They Want by Sarah Strohmayer, another art copy, actually we have a finished copy, and The Geography of You and Me by Jennifer E. Smith. The Murder Complex by Lindsay Cummings.
This is actually an ARC and I cannot wait to read it. I've only heard such great things.
And it comes out in July, right?
Yeah.
The Art of Lainey by Paula Stokes. Secrets and Lies by Jacqueline Green. You Only Live Once. The Museum of Intangible Things. The Rules for Disappearing. And Better Off Friends. Ketchup Clouds by Annabelle Pitcher.
And again, this is another contemporary book where the girl does something that she isn't proud of and she actually keeps sending letters to a person who is in jail. It sounds really interesting and I absolutely loved it. So if you're looking for, again, a contemporary that is a little bit different than all of the others you have read, pick this one up.
The Effortless, Invisible, Famous Last Words, Not Your Ordinary Wolf Girl, Maybe Tonight, Anywhere But Here, Zoe Letting Go. And over here we have two books. The first is A Great and Terrible Beauty and the full Balefire series by Kate Ternan.
The Ruining by Anna Collymore, and this is a psychological thriller, and again, I've been recommending this book in probably every video I can, and if you just are looking for a psychological thriller, it's a mystery, it will like mess up your head, and it's just an amazing, amazing contemporary. Pick this one up, please. It will be worth it. Then we have the Elemental series by Bridget Kimmerer, Eternity, Starcursed, which is the second book in the Cahill Witch Chronicles by Jessica Spotswood.
So I've read Born Wicked and I enjoyed, then I read Starcursed and fell in love. The ending of that book is killing me. I am going to be super jealous of anyone going to BAA and getting Sister's Fate, but yes, it comes out in August, so I guess I'll have to wait till then, and I'm just dying to find out how this whole trilogy ends. This is definitely for witch fans as well as historical fans.
Frozen, Sea of Shadows by Kelly Armstrong, Confessions of a Hater, Bound and Tangled by Erica O'Rourke, which are actually a very good magic series. Notable by Marnie Bates. 6 months Later, The Friday Society, Truly Madly Deadly,
which is a really cool murder mystery.
And Crash Into You by Katie McGarry. Welcome Caller, this is Chloe. Then we have Golden Girl. Then we have The Program by Suzanne Young. And this is probably one of my favorite dystopian books I have ever read. It is a duology and I recently read The Treatment, and it is actually with my friend right now, so we cannot show it in this bookshelf tour. The Treatment was an amazing ending to the series. I'm really sad to see it finished, and if you're a dystopian fan and you have not read this, China, I don't know what you're doing, because this is an amazing dystopian series. A Third Moon by Nina Barry. This is What Happy Looks Like. Anything to Have You, The Almost Truth by Aileen Cook, Things I Can't Forget, When You Are Here, Speechless, Burning, Envy, Rose Under Fire by Elizabeth Wine, Mind Games, and The Queen of Kentucky. Angel Dust, Before My Eyes, Enrique's Journey, Guardian, Never Enough by Denise Jaden, another one of my all-time favorite contemporaries, The Sound of Letting Go, Blues for Zoe, 359, A Breath of Air, See Jane Run by Hannah Jane, Ostentatious, A Touch of Scarlet, and Two Copies of Losing It by Cora Carmack.
So we have The Rescue by Nicholas Sparks, and this is actually one of my favorite adult books. The Runner, another Nicholas Sparks book, The Choice, Louis Bakshaw's The Movie, a Marion Keyes book, Sushi for Beginners, The Guardian by Nicholas Sparks, Fanning, Old Flames, Stand By Me, and Guilty Pleasures. Over here we have 101 Things to Do Before You're Old and Boring, Hatchet, Banana Splitville, and Rocky Road Trip.
And if you're wondering, this isn't actually a book to read, because if it were, it would have been pretty funny. This is actually a list of things to do.
Oopsie.
Before you're old and boring.
Yeah, like,
so it's one of those fun books that you just fill out.
Make a difference, do something nice, learn to juggle, pretend to be ill convincingly. We need to do this because we have become old and boring without
doing this. We actually have two copies, and
I don't know where the other one went.
Where did your copy go?
Then we have some limited two middle grade books, a Meg Cabot book, The Secret Ingredient, Girl Overboard, and a couple more ARCs. There is Ada Adams Revamped, another copy of Spirit by Bridget Kemmerer, Captives, Blaves, The Moon and More by Sarah Dessen, How I Lost You, The Lucy Variations, Over You, Touched, The Other Normals by Ned Vizzini, and Truth or Dare, as well as Decked with Holly and Stealing Parker by Miranda Keneally. And this side, The Reckless Journal, I have a movie, Pride and Prejudice, which is one of my all-time favorite movies. Our only audiobook, Monstrous Beauty, another copy of Rocky Road Trip, A Fool's Errand, The Fifth Business, or Fifth Business and Archetype.
Then we have Throne of Glass, Matched and Crossed by Ali Condy, Clockwork Princess, Cold Kiss, Everneath, Unleashed, Wildfire, The Immortal Rules by Julie Kagawa, The Lost Girl, Our Starlight and Vanish, both by Sophie Jordan. The Scorpio, Black City, The Scorpio Races, Fire with Fire by Jenny Han and Siobhan Vivian, one of my favorite series ever. Poison Princess, Darkness Falls by Kate Ternan, Tandem by Anna Jarzab, The Book of Blood and Shadow by Robin Wasserman.
And I recently read this book and I fell in love. It was totally unexpected. Historical with some magic and conspiracy and adventure and just everything you ever want in a book, and I loved it, so I will be recommending this book a lot.
Read All-American Girl by Meg Cabot. I've actually reread this book like a couple of times and it's a very good book. We have The Espressologist and Bright Young Things by Anna Godsberson.
Loud Awake and Lost, Paper Valentine, The Gathering Storm, Glimmer, Relic, Incarnate, Bumped, Sea of Shadows, Possess, Origin, The Best Night of Your Pathetic Life, The Last Echo, Swear, Insignia, The Forsaken, The Catastrophic History of You and Me, Article 5 by Kristen Simmons. This is the first book in the Article 5 trilogy, and I truly love this dystopian trilogy. It's very underrated, not a lot of people know about it, but I recommend all dystopian fans to check it out. The Lion Game, Born Wicked, Just Listen, Starstruck, and the full 5 volumes of the Sweep trilogy series by Kate Ternan.
Then we have The Casual Vacancy and The Cuckoo's Calling by J.K. Rowling, along with all of the Harry Potter series by J.K. Rowling. Then we have The Host by Stephanie Meyer, which is actually an all-time favorite for both of us, me and Jahainam.
And nothing like the movie. If you watched the movie and hated it, then yeah, because we also hated the movie, but this is an amazing, amazing book. Just disclaimer, the first 80 pages are very, very slow and confusing. Yes. After you get past those,
just go through them.
You will love this book.
Then we have the complete Twilight series, 2 copies, which one is for me and one for Jahainam. And please don't go on saying that you hate the Twilight series just because of the movies or just because of the fan base, because the books are actually good.
I enjoyed the books back in the day, and also Shout Down the Moon by Lisa Tucker. This is another one of my favorites, and it's just a very emotional book, and it has a music theme, so fans of contemporary books that want to branch out of YA should definitely check this book out. There's Ditched by Robin Mellum, a very, very fun book. Farah and I truly love this book.
And this is actually told in just one day, which is her prom night, and
it's a laugh out loud kind of book.
Definitely.
Then we have 2 copies of the first and second book of the Summer I Turned Pretty trilogy, 52 Reasons to Hate My Father, Point of Retreat by Colleen Hoover, Saving Francesca, Someday, Someday, Maybe, Bunheads, Pretty Tough, Head Games, Who I Kissed, 5 Flavors of Dumb, The Art of Truth or Dare, 40 Things I Want to Tell You, If I Stay by Gail Forman, and this is one of my favorite contemporaries. I cannot wait for the movie, the trailer just broke my heart. If He Had Been With Me by Laura Nolan.
And again, I'm going to talk about this book again in every single video, and this book is probably one of my all-time favorite contemporaries. It's just amazing, and it had made me cry and laugh and basically every emotion out there. And
I love the cover.
And this book is a book that is very close to my heart.
Codename Verity, 10 Things We Did and Probably Shouldn't Have, which is a book I seriously need to read, but for some reason I always push it back. I don't even know. 7 Clues to Winning You, Jane, The Confessions of an Almost Girlfriend, Confessions of an Angry Girl, Royally Crushed, Out of Sight, Out of Time, Promises to Keep, Dear John by Nicholas Sparks, Tan Lines, Beach Blondes, Rosebush, Riptide by Lindsay Sheeb, which I really liked, Peaches, A Time for Dance, Just Listen, Being Nikki and Runaway by Meg Cabot, and Jinx, as well as How to Be Popular. So these 4 are actually Meg Cabot books. Then we have Weather Witch, Zen and Xander Undone, another copy of Pivot Point, Don't Breathe a Word, Veronica Mars, the $1,000 Tan Line, and I'm a big Veronica Mars fan, and I read this and it's very true to the show as well as the movie. And lastly, it's Gloss.
Sorry for the glare, guys, but the light is very bad over here. Anyways, we have Flashpoint, Unravel Me, Shatter Me, Still Starcrossed.
So these are all arcs, just FYI.
Yes. Siege and Storm, Surrender, Dark Seeker by Taryn Browning, Slide, Spark, Control,
which I really, really loved, which is a really good sci-fi book that focuses more on the science, and I just really enjoyed that.
Prodigy, The Ward, Mila 2.0, Eve, A Matter of Days, The Rule of 3 by Eric Walters, The Burning Sky, The Originals, The Offering, Perfect Ruin by Lauren DiStefano. Perfect Ruin is actually a very good book. Then we have Berserk,
Reloaded,
Monument,
which is a sequel to Berserk.
Monument 14, Sky and Fire, which is the sequel to Monument 14, When We Wake and In the After.
Here we have Bloodlines by Rochelle Mead, The Dream Thieves and The Raven Boys by Maggie Stiefvater,
which I really, really love, and I can't wait for the third book.
The Glass Casket, The Coldest Girl in Cold Town by Holly Black, which is actually a really fun vampire book, and I really liked it. Then we have The Fifth Wave by Rick Yancey, Etiquette and Espionage, and All Our Yesterdays by Kate Terriel, which is one of my all-time favorite time travel books, and it is a really great book.
Then we have Three, which is the last book in the Article 5 trilogy by Kristen Simmons, Life After Theft, Perfect Escape, Thornhill by Kathleen Peacock, the second book of the Hemlock trilogy, and you guys know how much I love Hemlock as well as Thornhill. We have Endless, Emblaze, Entice, and Embrace, the first four books in the Violet Eden Chapters series, School Spirits, Far, Far Away, Underworld by Meg Cabot, Faded, The Lost Prince, Imposter, Drain You, The Eternity Cure by Julie Kagawa, Goddess Interrupted, The Goddess Test. Actually, The Goddess Test is a finished copy. I don't even know what it's doing there. The Chaos of Stars, Ink, The Goddess Inheritance, Thormoon, Thorkin, and Thursphere, The Believing Game, and Gated. The Eye of Minds by James Dashner, and yes, we do have a hardcover, but this is the ARC. Wake by Amanda Hawking, Pretenders, Love Me, Shadowlands by Kate Bryan, Crash by Lisa McMahon, Eternally Yours, the third and last book in the Immortal Beloved trilogy by Kate Ternan, Born of Illusion, Unbreakable, A Fool's Errand, Sweet Evil, Ravenflight, Who Needs Magic, Through the Zombie Glass, Cold Fury, Soul Thief, The Dark Between, Scorched, Teardrop, Half-Lives, Icons, Unremembered, and finally, Pawn by Amy Carter.
So finally, we are done with filming our bookshelf. You guys know
currently know all the books that we own.
Yes.
And we will probably do a bookshelf after one other year. And
I don't even want to think about that.
Honestly, we don't have any more space. Every single day, we keep on like stacking our shelves, so hopefully we might get another bookshelf to put somewhere.
I wonder how our parents would feel about that.
Happy. Yeah, they already think we have too many books. But yes, that's all. I hope you guys enjoyed this very, very long video. Yes. And have a nice day. Bye.